with Tourism Secretary Cristina Frasco. Secretary Frasco, so your aim for 2023, you said, is something like 4.5 million foreign visitors.
4.8.
I'm sorry?
4.8.
And we had 2.6 million in 2022. So your aim is almost double. How do you expect to achieve that? What steps are we doing to have 2.2 million visitors in the Philippines? 2.2 million visitors come to the Philippines. How would you achieve that?
Well, first of all, Karen, the effort is to ensure that the Philippines is open and ready to receive tourists from all over the world. And that is why we have improved the entry protocols into the Philippines, such as the removal of the One Health Pass and the implementation of a consolidated platform that requires information from five government agencies into one application, and that is the e-travel pass. We're also currently working with the Department of Transportation in terms of improving certain key gateways in the Philippines, as far as improving systems management and efficiencies and in handling departures and arrivals, as well as aesthetic improvements to these gateways. These include Naia Terminal 2, Cebu City Pier 1, and the Davao International Airport. We're also launching the Philippine Experience, which aims to attract travelers from all over the world, as well as domestic travelers, to explore our regions, and not only to discover the destinations themselves, but all the other components of the destination, such as our festivals, our food, our products, and the like. In addition to this, we've recently launched the Bisita Be My Guest program, a guest incentive program that aims to give incentives to overseas Filipino workers, as well as long-staying Filipinos abroad who bring a foreign friend, guest, or spouse into the Philippines. This is also open to residents of the Philippines. We will give them raffle prizes, discount cards, a travel passport that they can stamp all over the Philippines and exchange for prizes at the airport. We aim to give opportunities for our fellow Filipinos here and abroad and the chance to be tourism ambassadors for our country, and to tap into the over 12 million diaspora of Filipinos all over the world.
Mm. And you think these steps would be enough to actually make you reach the target of 4.8 million visitors for 2023, ma'am?
Well, certainly the effort is towards accomplishing that goal. Not only this, the directive of President Marcos has really been to not just take an outward look for tourism in the Philippines, but also an inward look to understand what it is that needs to be done to strengthen the industry from the ground up. And that is improvements in infrastructure, which is why we're working with the DPWH for this purpose, for the improvement of roads, bridges, drainage systems, water systems in key destinations, improvement of gateway access, digitalization of tourism services. We've recently inked a memorandum with the DICT for purposes of improving internet connectivity in at least 94 destinations all over the Philippines. It's also about enhancing the overall tourist experience, which is why we've broken ground on 9 of 10 tourist rest areas all over the country that aim to provide clean and decent restrooms, an information center, and Pasalubong Center for tourists. And most importantly, we've aggressively pursued shared tourism governance to coordinate closely with our local government units, our governors, our mayors, district representatives, as well as private tourism stakeholders from across the cross-section of tourism sectors. We're also improving our accreditation standards to include incentives for green and sustainable practices, as well as those that incorporate the Filipino brand into their services. Okay. So it's an amalgamation of a lot of efforts.
But I know that we do have challenges, and I wanted to ask you, how do we win Chinese tourists back? Just recently, a report came out that Chinese tourists, of course, with the reopening of mainland China, there's been a big leap When it comes to outbound flight bookings by Chinese travelers, it jumped by 192% between December and January 3. That's compared to last year. And yet they're celebrating the Lunar New Year elsewhere, except the Philippines. Why is that? Do you know why they're celebrating the Lunar Chinese New Year in other places and not in the Philippines?
Well, I'm not quite sure what study that pertains to, but our data would show that Chinese tourists are in fact coming into the Philippines prior to their international borders having been closed by their government. Chinese tourists ranked around number 12 in terms of arrivals into our country. Yeah. At the moment, after them having opened, they're now ranked at either 8 or 9. Mm-hmm. And therefore, we are seeing a trickling of Chinese tourists into the country. It also greatly helps that our president had a very successful state visit in China, having met with President Xi Jinping, among many other high-ranking officials. And there, both leaders witnessed our signing of an implementation program to implement a tourism cooperation agreement that specifically focuses on the increase of tourist arrivals, building tourism infrastructure, exchange of best practices of our tourism professionals, and joint promotions. We're presently working with our tourism attachés in China for purposes of ensuring that we resume the commercial flights that were stopped during the pandemic and that we add charter flights to certain cities across China into destinations in the Philippines. One of the challenges, however, is really the provision of visas for Chinese tourists. And therefore, we are working with the Department of Foreign Affairs for purposes of exploring the provision of electronic visas, group visas, as well as visas on arrival. So we're working to ensure that we improve these conditions of entry into the Philippines, and that includes a cross-section of many components handled also by other agencies.
Okay, so are you pushing, so at this point, Chinese, what kind of visa do Chinese visitors need to go to the Philippines?
Whether it's a Chinese person or any other foreign national where visa is required, a tourist visa would be required if the purpose is for leisure travel into the Philippines.
Okay. All right. I wanted to read lang that report, no? So at least we're on the same page here. Global ticketing data aggregator Forward Keys reported that most of the Chinese visitors are in Macau, Hong Kong. Well, it's understandable. Then Tokyo, Seoul, Taipei, Singapore, Bangkok, Dubai, Abu Dhabi, and Frankfurt. So interestingly now, as far as the Middle East, all the way to Frankfurt, Germany. What is the target of the Philippines in terms of the ranking of Chinese visitors for 2023? Our number one foreign visitor secretary still Korean nationals?
It's now the United States, followed by South Korea. Prior to the pandemic, the visitors from China ranked number 2 to South Korea, reaching as high as over 1 million. And therefore, our goal, of course, is to take back those numbers and to exceed it. However, we are faced with the reality of challenges in terms of visas, as I mentioned earlier. And therefore, it's a work in progress, but we're working to make sure that we coordinate with our fellow government agencies so that we can ensure that the seamlessness of coming into the Philippines can really be improved.
Okay. I wanted to ask you, I mean, clearly you cited the success of President Marcos Jr.'s visit to China, but do you believe our foreign policy today, our stand when it comes to the West Philippine Sea, the rejuvenation of our relationship with the United States, do you believe this plays some kind of a role into the number of Chinese visitors coming into the country?
As I understand President Marcos's position as far as foreign policy is concerned, is that we are a friend to all and an enemy to none. And this friendship was very much affirmed during his visit in China. The Chinese government expressed fully their respect and admiration for our president, as well as their high hopes for the friendship between our both our countries to flourish in the years to come, recognizing the millennia of relationship that has existed even at the time of our forefathers. And so this friendship, this relationship really goes beyond current issues in the sense that we have a very deeply embedded heritage and culture that is also shared, and that is evident in our Filipino-Chinese community here in the Philippines. And that is why for us in the Department of Tourism, we are very optimistic that with this relationship being furthered by our president and with his position of exercising diplomacy, especially in difficult issues, that the Philippines is very much in a good place as far as tourism recovery is concerned.
What do you make, Secretary, of criticisms that the president travels too much? Some have cited that this is his eighth trip in 7 months, and some have said there's not much benefit to be gained by attending the World Economic Forum. The U.S. president didn't attend, the Chinese premier didn't attend. So what do you make of these criticisms?
Perhaps we can understand why certain quarters would lobby these criticisms for their own intentions as well. But the reality is that our president really is the best person to pitch for our country. I've personally witnessed his talent in this regard, as far as his visits to, say, places like the United States, specifically at the UN General Assembly and the Stock Exchange, where he was received very positively by global leaders and CEOs. I also saw this in other jurisdictions as well that we've had the opportunity to visit. Our president is working very hard to tell the world that the Philippines is open and ready for investments. And this effort is very much affirmed by the billions of dollars of investments that have been committed to our government by various companies and investors from the places that he has visited. And therefore, to our mind, this is greatly helping in terms of ushering in trade and investment and tourism into the Philippines.
All right. Now, in 2022, tourism revenues for the Philippines hit 209 billion pesos. What is your target for this year?
Well, of course, these visitor receipts, if I may emphasize again, Karen, well exceeds the targets that were set for 2022. And it exceeds by over 2,000% the visitor receipts that were received by the country in 2021. With a doubling of our targets this year, we also expect a doubling of these visitor receipts, further elucidating the great contribution that tourism has to our economy and the massive potential that it can have in terms of generating employment and livelihood opportunities for our fellow Filipinos.
And how would you then, a study also shows that the countries spending the most when they're in the Philippines are actually the South Koreans when they visit the country. What are you doing to, I'm curious because in the past they were number one. What steps is the Department of Tourism taking to win back our South Korean foreign tourists?
We have already begun to win them back by the fact that they now rank number two in terms of arrivals into the Philippines. And the effort really is to continue to ensure the cordial relations between our countries, first, and second, to ensure and assure our South Korean tourists that the Philippines is, as it has always been, ready to receive our South Korean friends. We have a love for many things Korean. And this love we very much demonstrate and with the warmth with which we welcome them. We're also ensuring that our tourism products that are very attractive to South Koreans continue to be developed, such as dive tourism, which is very popular in the Central Visayas in particular, as well as our English as a second language. Of course, we're also working with the Department of Environment and Natural Resources as far as ensuring sustainable tourism to manage multitudes of tourists coming into certain destinations. And we very much look forward to welcoming more of our South Korean friends to come into the Philippines.
Okay. My last question would be about the airport. I mean, considering what happened on New Year's Day, I mean, one would say that would affect somehow. Would you say that would affect tourism in the country? Because that was, there were losses of 100 billion pesos because of the New Year's Day fiasco. And Joey Concepcion believes that the privatization of NAIA will actually help boost Philippine tourism. Where do you stand, Secretary, on this? Should we already privatize our airports?
Providing a global standard at our gateways is essential to the success of any tourism effort of any government, considering that this is the first and last impression that tourists have of our country. And therefore, we are in full support of modernizing and improving inefficiencies in present airports to bring them up to a standard that is at par with our ASEAN neighbors as well as the destinations across the globe. The airport in Cebu is the best example of the success that privatization can have in improving airport services. And therefore, from my end and DOT, I would support the privatization of our airports in terms of increasing quality of services. At the same time, I recognize the efforts that have been made by the Department of Transportation to work with the systems that are already in place. And we have a collaboration with them in terms of improving the touch points of tourists in the airport. And this is an ongoing collaboration that we will, the fruits of which we will soon see at the three identified benchmark gateways.
All right. On that note, Secretary Frasco, we wish you success. And we know that tourism is the backbone of many countries, especially in Europe and other parts of the world that have actually saved the economies of many countries. So we do hope really for a boost in Philippine tourism under your term. Thank you, ma'am.
Dagang salamat. Thank you, Karen.